Howdy, everyone. Welcome to part two in our series of using HR data in GenAI systems. Today's scenario is going to be accessing HR data during user interactions. So we really want to look at these interactions and look at them very closely. Now, of course, the concern we have here is we want to make sure that we are doing responsible and secure handling of the sensitive information, whether it's PII, personally identifiable information, or sensitive personal information. Now, let's take a step back and look at a GenAI system and how we're going to interact with it. So we always start with, we have a GenAI application. We have a large language model. Now, this has been trained off of a massive amount of data to provide human-like responses back to a user. So we have a prompt. User asks a question. It goes to the LLM. It brings a response back. But in this case, we want to bring HR data into the mix. Now, LLMs typically never use any kind of PII or sensitive personal information as part of their training. We want to fine-tune externally with HR data to manage that. So what we'll do is we'll have HR data in a source system. We're going to bring that into a vector database. We may actually have some chunks that we pull out as well. And we're going to feed that into our system. And then this way, we can get access to enterprise information and make that part of our prompt and part of our system. Now, this is where the securing comes in. We want to make sure that our data that we're bringing back is secure for bringing out to the user. Now, in our first video, we actually looked at a developer and as they were building out and fine-tuning the system and how they were interacting with the system and keeping that secure. In this video, we really want to look at the user and the information that is flowing out and make sure that stays, you know, secure and responsible. So we have a set of use cases that we will look at. The first one is really around process automation. Now, this is one place when we're talking about GenAI, we can really get some very big advantages and really streamline the processes that we use in HR by integrating HR data into the whole system and actually being able to prompt and ask questions. So let's say we have a scenario where a user, maybe this is a manager, and they want to interact with the system to do an employee promotion. So now, instead of just a prompt and response, we also are bringing into HR processes into this. So what we want to do is the manager asks a question. We have to pull information about the employee. So that could be personal information. That gets fed. We prompt in. We get information. We prompt with the LLM. But we also now want to integrate into the process. In other words, we want to know what are the steps. A manager may say, hey, what's the first step that I need to do to promote an employee? We go to the process. We understand what the process is. We bring that back. Now we need additional information. So we extract that out of our HR data. And we keep interacting back and forth, not only with the processes, but also with the data. The second use case we want to do is really looking at ESG reports. So this is environmental, social, and governance. These are reports that are now becoming part of filings for enterprises and companies. And we want to actually be able to have a user, again, go in, extract the information out of the systems that are needed to report on ESG, bring that, and create a report. And of course, that's based off of a lot of sensitive information. And we want to make sure that what comes out is actually secure and responsible and appropriate for the person and for the report that's getting generated. All right, so these are our use cases for today. So let's look at some strategies on how to actually manage these. So the first strategy that we really want to talk about is do not use the GenAI system to do controls, to do access. So this really says that when a user is interacting, we don't want the GenAI system to actually determine what the user can see or not see in the HR data and then just ask for it and bring it back. What we really want to do is use the existing controls that we have in place and leverage those. So this is really information that we're seeing down here. The controls exist in the source data systems themselves. So we want to leverage that. The next thing we kind of want to look at about using access controls is we want to make sure that we propagate the identity of the user through the system so we can check the appropriate controls. So we know that the user themselves, they have an identity. They authenticate themselves and they carry that identity. The GenAI system agents might also have an identity, and we'll see more and more of this in the future. Of course, we do know down here that that person, the individual, as an identity, has certain access rights. And we want to make sure that this identity, maybe coupled with that identity, are propagated through the entire system so we can leverage and use the right controls to access the data and feed that data back to the systems, whether they're asking about process, about promoting an employee, or they're trying to generate reports. All right, next thing we want to do is make sure that we apply data masking. Now, this is important, especially in our use case on ESG. So we want to bring reports back with a lot of information, and we're basically going to summarize it up and give a summary report, which may or may not contain information we want to expose. The thing we have to understand is if the sample size of people that are queried in the report come back small, then it might be possible to re-identify those individuals, and we don't want to do that. So what we do is apply data masking appropriately so that we can and bring it back and make sure that we don't ever expose any identifiable information. Now, third strategy that we want to apply when we're doing this is to make sure that we are always monitoring and available for audit. So this is important as well. We want to, now that we actually have users really interacting with systems and we're interacting with data, which is a very sensitive nature, and we're integrating with processes, we want to make sure that we're always kind of watching and making sure that we understand the interactions that are happening with the user in the system. And we want to look for misuse. Make sure that the system is not being used in a way that we didn't expect it to happen. And then, of course, we want to make sure that we store evidence of all these interactions. So if we need to, at some point, we can actually go back, audit what's happening, look at everything that's going on, and verify that the system is behaving the way we want it to. Now, this can also be, it doesn't necessarily have to look for violations. We can also look for the behaviors of the system and use that to come back and retrain and refine-tune our models to make sure it behaves in the ways that we want. So this is our scenarios for today. We looked at how do we actually start looking at the interactions of the user and leveraging sensitive data, and what are our strategies for doing this. Thank you very much for listening to this. I do want to give a shout out to my partner Pietro Mazzolini on this. He's worked very close with me on these HR topics, and I invite you to watch other videos in this series.